You know all that material that gets plucked and abraded, as in scooped up and ground away by glaciers, and then transported? Eventually, it gets deposited as glacial depositional and/or aggradational landforms. Remember, if you have a V-shaped valley, this is a river valley, and a glacier goes through it and hollows it out into a big U-shaped trough, all that material that was there gets dropped someplace. Glaciers, when they deposit material, deposit as a catch-all that we call drift. This is all glacial deposition. We refer to everything that gets deposited by a glacier as drift. However, drift is then further subcategorized into till and outwash. Till is unsorted glacial deposition. What that means is this: when a glacier picks material up and transports it, it does not do what running water and wind both do, which is it doesn't do this in a hierarchy. With a glacier, everything gets picked up at the same time, transported at the same rate, and dropped at the same moment. Big stuff, little stuff, hodgepodge, willy-nilly, helter-skelter. Okay? That material that gets deposited directly by the glacial ice, we call till. It's unsorted. That means non-hierarchical glacial deposition. Big stuff, little stuff, all together. At the same time, glaciers, of course, melt. And as they melt, water is going to run away in the form of a river or a stream away from the snout of the glacier. Well, anytime you have running water always transports and deposits in a hierarchy. That running water that flows away from the snout of a glacier, we call outwash. And outwash is sorted glacial deposition. In other words, what it is it's transported and deposited in a hierarchy. But of course, this is not by the ice itself. This is by the water that the glacier has turned into as a result of melting. For our purposes, the main glacial landform is going to be various types of moraines. A moraine is a hill composed of till that's formed along the edges of a glacier. And for our purposes, again, there's four types of moraines. Generally, people see five types of moraines. I want you to know four of them, which are the terminal moraine, the recessional moraines, lateral moraines, and medial moraines. Take a look at this picture. Everything you see, the hill on the right-hand side over here, the hill on the left-hand side over here, is all forms of drift. Okay? Drift, remember, is everything's deposited by a glacier. There's a glacial ice right there. But if you look carefully down here where the orange arrow's at, and I have the word till, that is till because it's deposited directly by that ice. And take a look at it. It's big stuff, little stuff, rocks, gravel, sand, even a part of a tree all mixed together. That's what till is about. If you look at this diagram, the red arrows are pointing at the terminal moraine. The terminal moraine is formed along the snout of a glacier, and it indicates the greatest glacial advance. If you look on this diagram, you can see the glaciers right here. There's a glacier coming down out of the mountains, but this is the snout. You can see that there are these rivers running away from the snout. That's going to deposit outwash, sorted glacial deposition. However, as the glacier comes down through the valley, everything that's out in front of it is going to be shoved up and just piled up all together, as is everything along the sides of it. That will be till, and that will form our moraines. You can see right here the terminal moraine that indicates that what happened is that glacier came all the way out to here at one point. And the terminal moraine indicates the greatest glacial advance. That's as far out as a glacier ever went. However, as the glacier begins to recede, as it begins to melt back, typically what's not going to happen is the glacier is not going to reach its greatest advance and then go all the way back over the mountains as quickly as possible and disappear. It will go back kind of in fits and starts. And as it does that, it may pause, for example, where you see that blue arrow, or over here where I'm pointing out the snout of the glacier at this moment. And it may pause there for, I don't know, 5 years, 10 years, 50 years. When it does that, it's going to create a new moraine along its snout. This is known as a recessional moraine. Recessional moraines form along the snout and they indicate a period of equilibrium in a receding glacier. Now, there can only be one terminal moraine, but there can be multiple recessional moraines going up that valley as the glacier pauses in its retreat. Then you'd see the green arrows are pointing at lateral moraines. Lateral moraines are formed along the sides of the glacier, and they indicate the former width of the glacier, in other words, how wide the glacier was. Take a look at this picture. You can see the red arrows pointing at a glacier that's coming down out of this mountain. Okay, there's the valley right there. The glacier's pouring down out of there. We have mountain over here. That's the snout of the glacier right here. And now notice this. All of this kind of lumpy mashed potato looking stuff, that's the terminal moraine. What you're trying to discern is anomalies on the landscape, or are anomalies on the landscape. Solid rock mountain here, solid rock mountain over here, right? Glacier here. And then the glacier would have come down out of the valley and shoved all of this stuff forward, creating this terminal moraine. This is another terminal moraine. Do you remember the tarn I showed you, Convict Lake? Okay, well, that tarn is sitting in a cirque. That cirque was once filled with glacial ice, and that valley comes down like this away from that tarn, and then it piles right up here. That would have been the terminal moraine for that cirque that comes out of where Convict Lake is at. And you can see we have mountain over here, we have mountain over here, all solid rock. In the foreground, you can see this kind of sagebrushy, deserty kind of landscape. This is Highway 395 up near Mammoth. And then right there is this weird lumpy mashed potato thing, which is the terminal moraine. Take a look there. Those orange arrows are pointing at lateral moraines. You can see the glacier comes down on the mountain like that. It obviously went all the way down here because you can see there's a moraine here and a moraine here that formed along the side, indicating the width of the glacier once was in that area right there. Then you can see same glacier, same lateral moraines, but we're up on top of the glacier looking down at it. Remember I just showed you the till here a few minutes ago? Okay, so if you look right there, that's lateral moraine, that's lateral moraine, which means all of this at one point was all filled up with glacial ice. This is up in the Sierra Nevada. That last picture was in France, but this is in the Sierra Nevada. And you can see, do you remember that alluvial fan I showed you? There it is right there. There's the S-shaped valley coming down to the mountains. There's the alluvial fan. Well, you can see up here, there's a cirque right there. There's a cirque here. A glacier would have come down here. And if you were here, this is near Bishop, California. If you were here, say 15 or 20,000 years ago, there would have been a glacier going right through here. But now you can see, look at that. Those are lateral moraines. This is the same picture you've seen now multiple times. There would be a lateral moraine here and a lateral moraine here. But notice that these two alpine glaciers are coming together just like these two alpine glaciers are coming together. When two alpine glaciers meet, the lateral moraines between the glacial ice are shoved together, creating what we call a medial moraine. Medial moraines are formed when two lateral moraines meet between alpine glaciers.